What's up, chicas? Welcome back to my channel. Today is going to be a beauty hack video. I want to start getting out more videos for you guys, like you guys can actually relate to and you can actually put into practice, rather than just sitting here telling you what product you need to buy, what product you need to have. So I'm going to jump into this video really quick because I do have a lot of beauty hacks that I want to share with you guys that I have incorporated into my life during the years I've been doing beauty, not only due to YouTube, but also just pretty much doing my makeup. So I have a couple of things that I have actually tried out in my life and they've actually worked wonders. So I thought I'd share with you guys, my viewers, some of these beauty hacks you probably heard about. You probably still do. You probably saw the YouTubers talk about it. You probably read it online because it's beauty hacks that are pretty much everywhere. So I have a couple of beauty hacks for you guys. So if you guys want to know what beauty hacks have worked for me and made my life a lot easier and simpler, all you have to do is grab a snack and join me. So in the morning when you wake up, you want to look alive, you want to look refreshed, like you didn't go to bed 4 hours ago. So I recommend starting your makeup, starting your day with a pretty much awake morning routine, I will call it, and mine consists of washing my face with an exfoliating cleanser. But exfoliating your skin, it works great. Also, if you have a cleanser that is that usually I use the Aveeno Daily Scrub because it actually has like skin brightening, so it actually helps it. Also, the Clean and Clear has a morning burst, which is really, really good. So the other thing is, of course, the other thing is a eye brightener. You want to bring brightness into your eyes. If you're not gonna wear any makeup, I highly recommend this one. There's also other steps in this video that is gonna help you brighten up your look, but I recommend an eye brightener after. And then of course, never forget to moisturize your face, because your face is gonna look moisturized, so you're gonna look alive, like you literally spend 10 hours sleeping in your beauty sleep because your face looks alive and refreshed. So that is very important, an exfoliating, an eye brightener, and a moisturizer to make your face look like it had a beauty sleep and you only had like 4 hours of sleep. So the other thing is, if you want to skip the whole makeup thing in the morning, like applying a corrector, primer, moisturizer, and then applying your foundation, jump right into a CC cream. I think a CC cream is great. You can use a BB cream. I preferably like to use my CC cream. This one is from It Cosmetics, and OMG, I love this CC cream. I definitely apply it when I'm just trying to cover up my face and I'm not trying to do a lot of makeup. As you can see here, I'm showing you, I'm applying it as I would do a moisturizer. I usually just do both hands all over my face, but because I want to show you the difference that it does, and it actually has amazing coverage. So one side of my face is done with the CC cream, the other one is not. You can see a huge difference. This is gonna save you a lot of time on your morning routine, because you don't have to be applying the whole color correcting or your primer or your moisturizer and then your foundation, and then you blend it, buff it, and set it, nothing. All you gotta do is apply your CC cream as you would a moisturizer, and apply a little bit of blush, a little bit of mascara, and you're out the door, and you look like you did spend time putting on your makeup. Another trick for looking awake and your eyes looking bright is to apply a white eyeliner on the bottom of your lash line, right on this area right here. Applying this is gonna make your eyes look a lot brighter, and it definitely is gonna help you look awake. Another thing that you can do to look awake is the way you apply your concealer. I highly recommend this step, do not miss it, which is color correcting your under eyes. It's definitely gonna help you a lot to be able to hide your under eyes if you weren't able to get a lot of sleep. So here I show you how I correct and conceal my under eyes. I first apply a color corrector, and the one I'm using is the NYX Cosmetic. And I'm gonna color correct my under eyes. It's a salmon-y color, so it actually corrects all the bluish and purplish that I have under my under eyes. And then after that is done, I'm going to apply my concealer. Now, this is very important. Apply your concealer in a triangle, in a triangular shape. Not just apply dots onto your face. So, triangle, yes. Dots, no. So the reason reason why is a triangle, because the triangle motion is going to be able to cover and highlight all this area right here, bringing a lot of highlight onto your face. If you only cover your dark under spot, you're actually just covering that area, so you're actually still pretty much going to be showing like, hey, I just covered this area, because everything else on my face is pretty much uneven color. So when you bring that triangle all the way down and blend it out, it's gonna help you bring brightness onto your face. So the other tip that I recommend is, if you don't have time to wash your hair and style it in the morning, I recommend dry shampoo. Dry shampoo is like my ultimate best friend. All I do is I actually part, I'm gonna show you right here, I part the whole front of my hair, so pretty much like in a square type of thing. Doesn't have to be so perfect. And what I do is I apply the dry shampoo, especially on this area because it's the top part, then under my bangs, the places where I apply the bangs, I tap it. Automatically it gives me a refresh boost to my hair, and I definitely feel it refreshed, and it smells really, really good. And you don't have to worry about actually shampooing every morning or shampooing. Dry shampoo, I think, has come to be my best friend throughout the years, because it actually saved me so much time. Talking about hairstyles, if you have long hair, I don't have long hair, but I definitely recommend this trick that I used to do when I had long hair. I would wash my hair, air dry it, apply a little bit of texture hairspray, and I will definitely comb my hair all to the side, and I will start braiding my hair the night before I had to go to work. So all I had to do was just pretty much do a simple braid, as I'm trying to do right now, because I don't have a mirror and I have such short hair, it's not even funny. So anyways, just try doing a braid, and then just pretty much tie your braid. Apply a little bit of more of your texture hairspray. I don't recommend doing like an actual hold hairspray, because it's not gonna work. So your hair is air dry, texture spray all your hair, especially your ends, and apply a braid. Maybe you have long hair and you can do a normal braid. This is not a normal braid. I should not even do this on camera. So you do a braid, you tie it up to the side, and you go to bed. In the morning when you wake up, you're going to have beautiful, loose, natural curls on your hair. All you do is then apply a little bit of your hold hairspray so it kind of holds in place, and walk out the door. So if you have long hair, you can definitely try that. I can't try it because it doesn't work. Now, other thing that I have actually tried is when I actually style my hair the night before and I want other waves, and I want a little bit of wave, I used to wrap my hair into a ponytail right here, and then all I did was pretty much put it into a bun, and instead of using a hair tie, one of these things, I used to place bobby pins all over just to hold it, and I would go to bed. And in the morning when I woke up, I had beautiful, not curls, but kind of a wave to my hair. It just used bobby pins to place your hair in its place, and then in the morning, you're just gonna have a beautiful wave. Not curl, but like a wave. That is for you guys, you girls, who have beautiful long hair and can do that. I cannot do any of those steps anymore because my hair is illegally short. For makeup, if you're going to do makeup, I highly recommend you keep it very simple and very fast. One tip that I recommend for you is to actually set up your makeup the night before. So pretty much place your makeup in your vanity of everything that you're going to be using. For your BB cream, your CC cream, to your concealer, to the eyeshadow palette you're going to use, and your lipstick. So like that in the morning, it saves you time and you're not running around like a chicken without head looking for your mascara, looking for your liner, you can't find it. So I highly recommend, saves you time to sort out your makeup the night before you go to bed. For makeup, I like to keep it very simple. I like to always use a palette that I can use on my whole entire face. My Holy Girl palette is the Shade and Light palette by Kat Von D, because I don't only contour my face with it, but I can also do an eye look with it. The other one that I've been loving is this Tarte. This is the Rainforest After Dark, and the fact that I like about this palette is that you have everything in one palette. That's the reason why I go for it. I have my eye colors, and I can definitely just do either a nude, or I want to do a brighter color with the purples. I have the blush in there, I have the bronzer to contour my face, and I have the highlight to definitely bring highlight to the face, and I have everything with me in one palette. So Shorting your makeup at the night before is definitely going to help you be able to sit down and say, okay, this is what I'm going to do. And definitely picking a palette that is going to do everything for you, from your contour to your eye look, is definitely, definitely worth it. So these are beauty hacks and beauty tips that I do. There weren't a lot. Maybe you've heard about them before, but I just wanted to share with you guys because it actually has worked for me throughout the years and I actually use it. I gotta say that the one that saves me the most time is my CC cream routine and my dry shampoo on my hair. It's the one that saves me the most amount of time in the morning when I'm trying to get ready. So I hope you found it helpful. Go ahead and leave me in the comments below down there what are your beauty hacks that you've tried that you say, friends, you didn't mention it here, but I've done it and it saves me either time, or it definitely saves me money, or it definitely just helps me in some way. I want to try your beauty hacks, so go ahead and leave me them to me on the comment section on the bottom. If you guys want me to go ahead and give you more informative videos, you know the drill. All you have to do is give this video a thumbs up, and if you haven't subscribed to my channel, go ahead and hit that subscribe button, because you won't regret it. Thank you so much for sticking till the end. Mwah, besotes, be blessed, precious pearls. And I'll see you ladies on my next video. Bye.